Medical surgery is putting two senior royals on the bench. In the early hours of this morning, news from the palace, Princess Kate is in hospital for significant abdominal surgery and will be out of action until Easter. Then just 90 minutes later, another one. King Charles sharing the news he will be undergoing a prostate operation. Let's go live to our Europe correspondent outside the London clinic where the Princess of Wales is staying. Edward, good morning to you. Both royals will be sidelined for some time.
Yeah, they will, Carl. And as you say, it's in this building right behind me, the London Clinic, where the Princess of Wales is currently recovering following this surgical procedure. She was checked in yesterday without word getting out. It was an alert from Kensington Palace, which shocked everyone, and advised that she'd gone in for planned abdominal surgery. Just reading a bit more from that statement, it says the surgery was successful, and it is expected that she'll remain in hospital for 10 to 14 days before returning home to continue her recovery. Based on the current medical advice, she's unlikely to return to public duties until after Easter. The exact nature of the surgery remains private, although it's understood that it's not cancer-related. It's also understood that Prince William will be pulling back from some formal engagements over the coming months to help look after his wife and their three children. There's a little over an hour after this news broke that an announcement came out regarding the King. King Charles needs treatment for an enlarged prostate. Buckingham Palace issuing a statement saying His Majesty's condition is benign and he will attend hospital next week for a corrective procedure. The King's public engagements will be postponed for a short period of recuperation. It's unclear exactly how long that is going to be. It's believed that some of those duties may be delegated to other senior members of the royal family. It is quite rare, Carl, that members of the royal family put out specific information like this. This is clearly something that the King wanted out there.
Edward, thank you. Welcome back to the breaking news this morning. There are health concerns for two of the top members of the British royal family. First, Kensington Palace released a statement the Princess of Wales is in hospital and will stay there to recover for 14 days following planned abdominal surgery.
90 minutes later, Buckingham Palace announced King Charles will head to hospital next week for a procedure. For more, we're joined by Associate Editor at The Telegraph, Camilla Tominey, live from London. Camilla, good to see you as always. Now, let's go first to the Princess of Wales. What do we know about her surgery?
Well, not too much, to be honest, Sarah. I mean, it was a shock announcement. Nobody was expecting it. It came at 2 p.m. my time, basically saying that she had undergone this procedure yesterday. But it was that length of time of recovery which has surprised people here. You know, 10 to 14 days suggests that she's had major surgery in the clinic behind me. And not just that, but that she will continue to recuperate, the royals say, until probably after Easter. So that's a significant chunk of this year out. And we know that very recently royal aides were prepared to give more details about the couple's forthcoming trip to Italy. They were due to go to Rome in the spring. That would have been their first royal tour together since they went to the Caribbean in March 2022. So the first royal tour in 2 years. And then suddenly this announcement has come. Yes, they say that she hasn't been rushed to the hospital, that this was a planned procedure, but it does seem as if it has caught them somewhat unawares.
A little bit of a stay in hospital too that raises certain questions. Obviously, we're not open to speculation on that, but it is quite the stay. It must be fairly serious.
And the other thing is what they've said sort of about the Prince of Wales and what he'll be doing. And it does seem to me that he will also be taking some time off to look after his wife back at their Windsor home, Adelaide Cottage, and make sure that the immediate family are OK. I mean, people watching this will sympathise. She's only 42. She's got three children under 10. She's got her hands full and they have been under huge pressure. Duchess of Sussex. You know, there's been a huge spotlight, particularly on Kate. And it's difficult because I think the last 12 months were a bit of an annus horribilis for the royals, what with Spare and all the revelations from that. They managed to get through the coronation, the first in 70 years, a huge amount of pressure on them. I think the King wanted 2024 to be a sort of year of stability and calmness. And now this appears to have thrown them somewhat off kilter.
Well, that's right. I mean, the King himself is now due to have surgery next week. Tell us more about that.
Well, that that was, again, rather extraordinary just in terms of timing. As you say there, 90 minutes after getting this initial statement from Kensington Palace about Kate having undergone surgery, we now learn that the King will have a procedure on an enlarged prostate next week. They say that it's benign. Obviously, at times when we hear about men in their 70s and prostates, we worry about cancer. That's been ruled out by the palace. So he'll undergo this procedure next week, and he too will have to step back from public life for a period while he recuperates. The palace did point out that this is an issue that affects lots of men of his age and that it's a standard procedure to correct it. But again, we're talking about the King, the Prince of Wales and the Princess of Wales, three of the four most senior royals in the monarchy, being out of action for a number of weeks.
There's always so much kind of clandestine, activity around the royals, especially when it comes to health. This is so unusual.
Well, it's unusual, and they've given more detail, haven't they, of the King's complaint and what he's having done than they have the princess's. Having said that, we can sympathise and understand it, can't we? I mean, she's a young woman. Yeah. It's really, in many respects, none of our business exactly what she's had done. In the fullness of time, she may want to speak about it more. And indeed, palace aides today haven't ruled that out, that she might want to raise awareness of what she's been going through over the course of the last weeks and months. But for now, they're keeping stum and are obviously and understandably asking everyone to respect their privacy.
Good on you, Camilla. Thank you so much. Lots happening there. Busy day. For more now on the news out of the Royal Palace today, Princess Kate is in hospital following abdominal surgery, and King Charles will head to hospital next week for a procedure. Former Palace Press Secretary Dickie Arbiter joins us now live from London. Dickie, lovely to see you. With your experience as Palace Press Secretary, to have two top senior royals out of action, it's unusual. What would be happening behind the scenes?
Very unusual, and I've never known it to happen in all my time there. What will be happening behind the scenes? Well, they might well be trying to fill some of the gaps vacated by Catherine. They might also be trying to fill some of the gaps that have been vacated by William, because he's made clear that as long as his wife is in hospital, he's going to stay with her, which means that the engagements that he had on his diary have now been pushed to one side, and until such time that she's home and he feels that he can go out and do some of the work, he'll stay with her. But it is unusual. What is interesting in this whole exercise is the transparency of the King coming out with that he is going for a prostate procedure. Now, I've been asked many times today, well, should he be talking like that? And you ask the prostate charities, and they will say yes, because they feel that men are reluctant to talk about it with their GPs. They're embarrassed to talk about it openly with their families. Mm. And with the King coming out and talking about it, that is going to encourage people to go to their GPs if they feel they've got a problem. And it's good on him. It wouldn't have happened without his say-so. So he's very much in tune with what is actually going on in the country when it comes to prostate issues.
Well, it's an indication, too, of no matter who you are, it can affect you. I presume, I mean, he looks pretty fit and healthy. I presume he gets checks regularly. And here we are.
Yep, here we are. He does get checks regularly. I think one of the things that he might not look like too much is that he would have to cut down on alcohol. He does like strong martinis. He is up at Burke Hall, probably kicking one back at the moment. But he is going to have to cut back on certain things, caffeinated coffee. He doesn't drink coffee anyway, so that is by the by. But it is good news that he's actually come out and talked about it. Somebody said to me earlier today, well, you know, isn't this revealing too much? Yeah, perhaps it is denting the mystique of monarchy, but we're in the 21st century and people should know about these things.
They have to do that. They have to do that. Look, also on strong martinis, a king after my own heart. I don't think there's such thing as a weak martini. Look, on the Princess of Wales, I think is particularly interesting as well and a little troubling. She's going to take 3 months to recover. We had no indication that she was sick in any way. She's undergone surgery. Will they reveal what it was exactly?
I don't think they will. She has asked specifically for people to respect her medical condition and not talk about it. Yeah. She certainly won't say anything about it. But, you know, when there are a lot of people around in the hospital, there are a lot of people, somebody is bound to say something. How true it is remains to be seen. already journalists in the UK are speculating. One is has come out today and said online that she's been told that it is benign cancer. Well, she hasn't been told anything because at the palace, nobody will say anything, either at Kensington Palace or Buckingham Palace. There's a lot of wild speculation at the moment, but you've got to remember, this is an abdominal operation, and abdominal operations can take a long time to heal. So she is taking that time. She might not be in hospital for 10 to 14 days. She might be out earlier. Who knows? That's up to her and how she feels. But William is there alongside, and that's good news. And he's there for the children too.
Dickie, you go and make yourself a nice martini, shaken, not stirred, my man. See